Welcome to my presentation on electronic devices and electric circuits. Myself Ananda Selva Karthik from Assistant Professor Department of ECE. And in this electron devices and electric circuits, we see about this Zener diode, and this is what the symbol and the actual Zener diode which we will be using in lab. Outline of this presentation is about introduction, construction, working of Zener diode, breakdown characteristics, and summary of this introduction. You can see the introduction is very, very simple. You can see it consists of anode and cathode. Once it is connected in a circuit, for example, you can assume it has a 10 volt Zener diode. Here they have mentioned this particular Zener circuit will work to if the circuit wants to maintain a 10 volt across the load. If I am using a 10 volt Zener diode, if my supply consists of 20 volt, it will be allowing only 10 volt beyond this component. So then because of this, it acts as a voltage stabilizer. And you can see Zener diode is a silicon PN junction device. The basic function of Zener diode is to maintain a specific voltage across its terminals. Construction, it is similar to that of a PN junction. You can see a Zener diode is a heavily doped to reduce the breakdown voltage. Because of this heavy doping, it produces a very thin depletion region, and its voltage is about, the rating is about 1.8 volt to 200 volt. And this is about the working of Zener. You can see this is forward biased, and this is reverse biased. The forward biased of ordinary rectifier, that is nothing but a PN and Zener is same. In reverse biased condition, voltage stabilization has to be performed. The graph is like this, a constant voltage is maintained. It is nothing but VEZ. So this is what the characteristics, VA characteristics of a Zener. A Zener diode is much like a normal diode. It is operated in reverse biased condition. And forward biased characteristics, it is works like a normal diode. Breakdown characteristics, as the reverse voltage VR is increased, the reverse current remains extremely small up to a knee point. This is what the VA characteristics. This is V and this is I. Up to a certain point, it remains constant. This is knee. After some time, it gets increased. You can see here the reverse current is also called as a Zener current. At this point, the breakdown effect begins. The internal Zener resistance is also called as a Zener impedance. Begins to decrease. The reverse current increases rapidly. So this is the Zener point, knee point. After this, the reverse current gate increases and the voltage remains constant throughout the operation. After this particular point. Zener breakdown. Zener and avalanche effects are responsible for such dramatic increase in the value of current at breakdown voltage. If the impurity concentration is very high, the width of the depletion is very less. And this is what the simple example, you can see the width is given as a 200 angstrom and the supply reverse bias voltage is 4 volt. If I want to calculate electric field, this is the formula 4 divided by 200 into 10 to the power minus 10. I'll be getting 2 into 10 to the power 8 volt per meter. This is what the field available in that particular region. Merely a voltage of 4 volt is responsible for this much of electric field intensity. What this electric field does is it rupture the bonds and separate the valence electrons from their respective nuclei, by this resulting in a sudden increase in the value of reverse current. And this was explained by Zener, therefore it is called as a Zener diode by its name. Another important thing, Zener effect predominant in diodes whose breakdown is breakdown voltage is below 6. If it is greater than 6, it is called as avalanche breakdown. And this is a common mechanism. Depletion region will be formed by electron hole pair, and this electrons from n region will drift towards the p region. If this process continues, it is called as a carrier multiplication, and the newly created electrons and holes contribute to the rise in the reverse current, and as a whole it is called as an avalanche breakdown. It will happen after some times like this, after some particular point. This is what the avalanche breakdown. And these are the comparison of Zener breakdown and avalanche breakdown. It is very simple. You can say it is heavily doped, it is lightly doped. A strong magnetic field will be created. Here a weak magnetic field will be created. And here, because of the strong electric field, large number of current carriers are generated. And this is a normal procedure. This is avalanche breakdown. And this Zener diode exhibits negative temperature. You can see breakdown voltage decreases as temperature increases, and avalanche diode exhibits positive temperature coefficient. The breakdown voltage increases with increasing temperature. This is what the summary of this presentation. A Zener diode is always operated in reverse biased condition. It can access a voltage regulator to maintain constant DC output voltage, and this is for practical application. Valve should be connected, and whether it is connected in series or parallel, and it can able to produce a stabilized output voltage, and the voltage is always selected to be the same as the breakdown voltage what we have seen in our first slide. Thanks for watching this presentation. Thank you.